In this video, we're given a small cart starting from rest at the rim of a hemispherical bowl. And this cart is going to roll into the bowl. We're assuming the wheels are small enough where we don't have to worry about rotational energy here. And of course, we're assuming the bearings in the wheels are nearly frictionless. And in part A, we want to compute the speed of the cart at the bottom of the bowl. So this is just an energy conservation problem with gravitational potential energy converting into kinetic energy. If I look at the height change of the cart as it goes from the initial to final state, I'm going to go ahead and call the lowest position y equals 0. And because this bowl has a radius of 55 centimeters, it means my starting position is a height of 55 centimeters or 0.55 meters. And by the time it rolls to the bottom of the bowl, that gravitational potential energy decrease is turned into a kinetic energy, and I get some final speed v. So we write down conservation of energy here, E initial equals E final. And in my initial state, I don't have any kinetic energy. All my energy is gravitational potential energy, and that's given by an mgy initial. And in my final state, I don't have any gravitational potential energy because I put the zero of my coordinate system there. So it's all kinetic, and I get 1/2 mv². Now the m's are going to cancel out of this, and I get a classic answer. Multiply both sides by 2 and take the square root, and I find out that the speed is the square root of 2g y initial. And we plug our numbers in, and I've got 2 times 9.8 times 0.55 meters for the initial height. And when I run the numbers on this to 3 sig figs, I get 3.28 meters per second. And I'll go ahead and put that into the second diagram. This thing is moving 3.28 meters per second when it hits the bottom of the bowl. In part B, we're asked to compute the normal force on the cart at the bottom of the bowl. So this is a circular motion problem. The cart is traveling in a circular path. I know the speed at this moment in time. So I diagram the forces that are acting on it. And I have gravity pulling down with a magnitude of mg. And then I have the normal force pushing up. And I know, because this thing is moving in a circular path, that the acceleration at this moment points to the center of curvature. And this means automatically the normal force must be larger than the weight. So I get a net force pointing in the direction of the observed acceleration. And we apply Newton's second law to this. I'm going to call upward positive, so I get n minus mg. That's the net force. That's got to be equal to ma, so m times the acceleration. Well, the centripetal acceleration is v squared over r, so mv squared over r. And I can solve for n, and I get that n is equal to mg plus mv squared over r. And we'll go ahead and factor the m out of this to get a nice symbolic solution. That's m times the quantity g plus v squared over r. And finally, we'll plug the numbers in. So this thing had a mass of 85 grams. That's 0.085 kilograms. G, we're using 9.8 as usual. V, we're taking from part A, and that was 3.28 meters per second. So I square that and divide by the radius of curvature here, which was 0.55 meters. And when I run the numbers on this and round to 3 sig figs, I get 2.50 newtons for the normal force. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.